It's quite unusual to see so many sober people at this location.
You're watching On the Beat on
Enter Berlin.
Nico, the founder of Tech Open Air. This is the second time that we've been doing it. We started last year. There's three things that we thought traditional conferences that we love were missing was something that was multidisciplinary, and we decided to go with tech, music, art, and this year science. Secondly, what we were missing was something that was really open, like an open platform where everybody in the ecosystem could participate in.
I'm the co-founder and CEO of Blista, which is an online advertising network. And to my left is Andreas.
And I'm also the co-founder of Blista. I'm CTO, CIO.
So he's doing the visionary stuff. I'm doing tax accountant. Actually, last year we've been the main sponsors. We carved up quite a bit of money to get a nice booth here. It was a good time, but this time we decided only to enjoy ourselves.
I think it's really great that it's such an open platform and it's not too commercialized somehow. It's not the big companies here.
We weren't so much interested in how much money did startup raise, who did they exit to and how many markets do they operate, what can their products do. Wouldn't it be interesting to get these founders of these successful startup companies to talk about other things, things that inspire them, to talk about things they learned along the way of building the company that they would like to pass on, or to talk about completely unrelated things to their own business, so just passions they have.
They even have dinosaurs over there.
Location is super cool, and I think that also they use the word open air. They played a little bit with this, because in Berlin when you listen open air, everybody's like looking around, what is the open air, what is the open air? So like Tech Open Air sounds really great.
I think there's a lot of parallelities between the party space and founding a company for there. Therefore I think it's important to have this event here at Katerholzig.
What are the similarities?
Parties are a lot about going out into the world and expressing yourself, but also being challenged with the reality afterwards. And with startups, it's kind of the same. You have this vision, you try to create reality, to express yourself, but you also coped with the realities of the external world.
Katerholzig is just, the perfect place to do it. Unfortunately, it's only going to be around for another few months. It was great to share the ride here at this place, because it's sort of exactly at the intersection of arts and music. So yeah, I couldn't think of a better place, and it's outdoor, which was important to us. We wanted to do something open air, which is more laid back in nature, so it fits really well.
A lot of talent to Berlin, and therefore I think that 2020 years on will be called the golden 20s again in Berlin, like 100 years ago. And this is the first time this is on video. I said this already quite some times. I want to be the owner of that statement. Golden 20s upcoming again. Thank
minus
you. 2020.
Minus morphine.
It'll be something else.
For sure.
Club Mate.
Thanks for watching Enter Berlin.
And don't forget to subscribe.